I actually think that this this bass might be a little bit too low. I'm gonna try a couple other notes, and I'm gonna try fiddling with the settings, see if we can make it sound better. I think maybe that that D sounds a little bit higher. Just like the range of it a little bit better. And I'm gonna hear it without the reverb. It sounds a lot cleaner. Maybe just a little bit, a little less reverb. Maybe reduce the room size a bit. Now that you can also turn on a filter here. Doesn't seem to do anything. Oh, it needs to be on. Oh, yeah. What is this? Oh, these are different, different parts of the equalizer, sorry. So there's only like a notch filter in the mid-highs right now. I was thinking of this filter. Oh, that's weird. Oh, no. Oh, I see these are for each individual low band, mid band, and high band. Now what I usually do is crank these up inside of the plugin. And then use this filter cutoff here. Check that out with that delay in there. How cool is that? So you can see where, even though you were starting with something real simple, you can really get some cool effects. Now, I want to be able to automate that delay. So right now it's embedded, this delay sound, is, you can see it's a dotted quarter, and it's synced to the tempo, and it's a ping pong delay. So instead, a better strategy is going to be to turn it off in this plugin and route it to a delay and make a delay track. So in the next video, what we'll do is we'll make an FX track that has a delay, and we'll send the bass through that so we can easily see it as its own channel here and mix with it and mess with it. All right. Thanks for watching. See you on the next one.